Breaking news, buffets are back. That's according to new analysis of the earnings at various buffet chains across the country. So let's get into the details here. Apparently they're making a comeback in Vegas, but we'll get to that in just a moment. Apparently, according to the New York Times in their very poetic language, they argue that buffets speak to an American dining culture that prizes consistency, value, and choice. They can make people of modest means feel rich if just for an hour or two. They provide culinary roadmaps for recent immigrants and culinary tourism for those who haven't traveled much. A buffet can be as communal as a church picnic. Kim Severson needs to calm down a little bit, okay? People like them because there's a lot of options for relatively little money.
I've never been to a church picnic and I love buffets. You're never gonna not get me to go to one. But let me break this down. But she's not wrong about the initial description. I don't know about consistency.
Yeah, consistency is an interesting word to use in the context of buffets.
Yeah, you don't often get consistency in buffets. But the other two are definitely true. One is choice. I never get why people don't always go to a buffet.
Because they can be gross. Like people are gross. That's the problem, right? No. Like you want to consume food that has been handled by as few people as possible.
Yeah, I hear you.
And people love to get their hands on everything.
Yeah, I hear you. I hear you. And I'm going to come back to that. I'm going to come back to it because actually it's a part of the story. But overall, why would I just want to eat one thing if I could have 100 things? And of the 100 things, I don't have to eat all 100. I can pick and choose like in tiny portions of like 8 things.
It's called tapas.
Yeah, it's called tapas, mezes, appetizers.
God, mezes are the best.
Yes, and what is a buffet? But tons and tons of mezes.
No, that's not what buffets are. Buffets are like full blown, like entrees.
Who cares? Yeah. I don't have the whole things. What am I gonna get filled on one thing? I'm not a rookie when it comes to buffets, okay?
What's your strategy?
My strategy is I take tiny little pieces. Mm-hmm. You know what I do? I start with the desserts.
Okay. Just desserts.
Okay, so I take a tiny bit of dessert, not the full dessert, just a little, like get a taste. Okay, start your palate out nice and fun way. Then I go and I get little pieces of everything.
Little nuggies.
That's right. And I fill my plate up with like 10 different things.
Oh God.
So, but why wouldn't you? So it's individual choice for the person, but it's also when you think about a family, it's critical. Because it's hard to agree what you want.
That's so true, yeah.
And the kids love the buffets because it's got ice cream, it's got this, it's got, they can get the pizza, they can get the mac and cheese, right? Depending on the buffet, obviously. The parents also love it because they can get the crab legs, etc. So it's got options. It's got all the food instead of some of the food. I just can't understand why you wouldn't love buffets. Except for the point that Anna made, which then goes to the heart of the story. It turns out the high-end buffets are doing really well and they're back, but the COVID killed a lot of the low-end buffets, which people were worried about.
So Hometown Buffet, which is or was a chain of buffet restaurants, ended up filing for bankruptcy in 2021 because COVID did a number on them. There was a period of time when buffets were kind of out of style in Vegas, but they're experiencing a reemergence. So the Bellagio buffet came back and it's apparently doing really well. Same with the buffet over at Caesar's Palace. Golden Corral, for instance, is doing really well right now. The chief executive for Golden Corral said this, the media called buffets zombie companies. We didn't know we were dead. But we're the comeback kids. Year to date, we're running about 20% up. So they're doing well in that regard too. And look, it is, not only do you have many options when you go to a buffet, it's also a more cost-effective way to go out to eat with a family.
Oh, come on, you guys, know? Think about that. For like at 20 bucks at Golden Corral, you could have like 18 different kinds of food. So I just don't see the downside. In fact, this is a great phenomenon because it weeded out the ones that weren't that good, right?
Oh, look at you, invisible hand of the market, Uygur.
Yeah, but kinda. I mean, look, I'll tip my too strong coffee to Hometown Buffet.
Oh my God.
Okay, but
by the way, my dad loved Hometown Buffet.
I love Sizzler, so.
Oh, Sizzler. Yes. Yeah. Does Sizzler still exist?
Yeah. Yes. I've seen it in a couple of places. And I even went recently, I took the family and I'm like, this is where we used to go. And they're like, really? I'm like, yeah, what are you talking about? This is great. So, but the strong have survived the weak ass buffets. And it's not like I haven't gotten sick at a buffet. Let's keep it real, okay? So the concerns are not unwarranted.
God, it's so disgusting.
But it was always at a super low end buffet, right?
So, remember how earlier in the show I said that people in news should probably avoid doing irresponsible speculation?
Yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah, so I'm about to engage in irresponsible speculation.
Fun.
But let me be clear, it is speculation and I have zero evidence of this. The only evidence I have is how I feel anytime I eat at a buffet. I think they put something in the food to make you full faster.
Ooh,
because
interesting.
Like, I'll take a few nibbles of something and I'm like, oh! Yeah. Like I'm so full, I can't walk.
Okay, so that's an interesting speculation, but that's might be because you're a rookie. As they explained in this New York Times article, they're like immigrant families, and you're from an immigrant family, but maybe you didn't get this, that have a culture where they are more resource constrained, so they're really worried about it. And I come from one of those cultures, gotta eat everything on your plate. When they go to a buffet, they warn the kids, don't eat the rice or the noodles, that'll get you full quicker, okay? It's a trick, eat the other stuff so you can eat more food, okay? Oh, so maybe you're a buffet novice, really your problem.
I would go straight for the mac and cheese.
See?
Does that make sense? But I have had many a nights with mac and cheese, and I can eat a considerable amount of it without feeling the way I do after eating mac and cheese at a buffet.
Yeah, I don't believe your speculation, but I really enjoy it.
Right. Okay. It's a good conspiracy theory.
I want to say one more thing about this. So I think that there's one other factor, and they mentioned it in the story too. As poetic as she did a thorough job with the story, okay? And they had good facts too. For the high-end ones, like the ones in Vegas, it kind of makes you feel rich.
It does. It right? does because so, they have. Look, the only time I've enjoyed a buffet has been at Vegas, and it's because if it's a good buffet in Vegas, a high-end buffet, you've got like crab leg mountains and like chocolate fondue fountains and like I don't know. It's special.
100%. Look, it's not like it's cheap. It's like $80 roughly. But you know, look, if you live in LA, at $80 is like two sandwiches and a couple of drinks, right? So, but for the $80, you get your money's worth because you feel like a king. You're like, look at all this amazing food. So
you know that some people wait as long as 2 hours in line to get into those Vegas buffets?
That's the only problem. I can't do that.
I think that is an abomination. And like in America, especially at a place like Vegas, you're drowning in food. Like you can't turn a corner without being confronted by a food product, okay? No one should be waiting to eat anywhere in Vegas.
So there's somebody who works at TYT who had read a book on the best way to go to Disneyland, the most efficient route through the park, okay, to get the most amount of rides in your time. I could write a book on the most efficient way to eat at buffets.
Oh my God. Okay.
Hey, you're not gonna be a rookie and go in the morning on a weekend, are you? Please tell me you're not doing that.
You gotta go on a Monday or maybe a Tuesday.
Yes.
But Wednesday it starts to get a little dicey at the amusement parks.
Look, read my book, tyt.com/justice. Okay, it's not in that book, but still, one day. Justice is coming, because the buffets are back. Justice and the shrimp are coming. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.